No. 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 Definitely no. 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 You know, it just isn't easy trying to find true love. No. No. It was recommended to me, this app. It said it touted alien singles in your galaxy. So I thought, okay, I would give it a try. It was advertising all kinds of single aliens looking for love. So, you know, I'm single and I'm looking for some real alien love myself. But I'm just not having any luck finding the right match, the right one for me. I don't know. It's been centuries since I've been on a date. But, well, enough of that. I do want to sincerely apologize for this inconvenience. I do hope that we here on our intergalactic space vessel didn't take you away from anything too important. No? Okay, very good. Because the last thing that I want to do is inconvenience you and ruin your day or your night. Anyway, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Tapufala, okay? And I am just one of the many, many Zingzazolats. That is the name of our species, but you often call us greys, or, greys, aliens. We're okay with that. But I want you to know that you have nothing, absolutely nothing to be afraid of. Yes, it's true. We did abduct you and take you away from your home, but it's just a temporary setback, okay? I promise you, once I'm done here with you, we'll return you back to home, your home on Earth, okay? Okay. Here, let me do a little something just to calm your mind. I'm sure you have a lot of thoughts a little anxious, maybe a little panic. Don't panic, okay? Just relax, okay? Just look at my beautiful fingers, chubby fingers. Do you see how calm I am? I want you to feel calm as well. Just relax. You have nothing to worry about. There we go. Just allow your mind to relax and be at peace, okay? Everything's okay. Everything's gonna be okay. I promise you. Here, just listen to this. To the sound of the pads of my fingers. Isn't that a pleasant sound? Sure, one of the questions that you have, why did I abduct you, take you away from your home on Earth? And I hope you don't mind this dark room. We like to use these rooms to help create a calm ambiance. I prefer black. Some of my other co-workers, they like to display knickknacks and fancy lights, but I'm kind of old school. Anywho, we are currently many kilometers above the Earth. I would show you, but it's kind of difficult right now. Anyway, you see, our race, our species, we are dying by a strange virus. There's only a few of us left. And so we've all gathered our belongings and we escaped our home planet onto this spaceship, as your species likes to call it. And, we need to repopulate our species, and we have some difficulty doing that. There's a nasty virus, really nasty. This nasty virus has caused our kind to go sterile. cannot reproduce anymore. And so, I know earlier I was looking for love from another alien. Well, obviously, there's all kinds of alien species. We just happen to be one of them. Our particular species is dying out. And that's where you and your kind come in. Okay? The reason I ensnared you, abducted you, is to obtain some of your DNA, okay? I hope you don't have a problem with that, okay? So, before we get into the DNA extraction segment of this little meeting, this little session of ours, I do need to perform some various tests, ask you some questions to make sure that you are the perfect specimen from which we will extract DNA from you. And we're going to use a syringe, a little cotton swab in the mouth, scrape, obtain a hair sample. That's how we'll extract your DNA, okay? So, just a moment. Let's see. So, as I mentioned, I have a few questions to ask you, okay? I hope you don't mind. Can I offer you something to drink? Are you comfortable in that chair? You are. Excellent, okay. So, the first question I have is, do you consent to us obtaining samples of your DNA? You do. Excellent. Question. Do you have any superpowers such as X-ray vision, flying, teleportation, etc.? Okay. next question. Do you have any anomalous qualities about you that would cause or has caused the foundation, the organization known as the foundation, to contain you and experiment upon you to in order to understand your anomalous qualities better? Okay. Questionnaire. Next question. Do you enjoy playing video games? Okay. Just two more questions to go. Next question is, do you experience the sensation, the phenomenon known as ASMR? In case you're not familiar, it's a tingling sensation, very pleasant. I experience it, and you feel it. It's triggered in response to various stimuli. So, do you experience ASMR? Okay. Okay, my friend, if I can call you that, I know that I have abducted you away from your home, and a strange alien abducted you, no less. And this is all quite overwhelming, but I would like to think that we have something going here. A little bit of a friendship developing. Maybe it's just me. Last question. Have you ever been... Have you ever been to a place called Arkham Sanitarium? And have you ever been subjected to various experiments during your stay there? Okay. Well, in just a moment, but I'm gonna just a little pinprick. I promise there'll be no and you won't feel a little sick, okay? I'm very good at, I'm a part-time nurse. Okay, not just some ragtag alien off the street who's abducted you. Okay, this isn't that kind of operation, as you can see. We are very professional here. So, I'm gonna put a needle on here, put the plunger, and then extract some of your blood, okay? Very painless procedure. All right, and that will be the first sample of DNA, okay? So, let me just put the needle on, put the plunger in there. Okay, and I'm just going to, just a small little prick, okay? In your arm. There we go. Just to extract a small little amount of DNA. A little bit of blood. Not much. And there we go. Okay. I'm not going to show you. In case you happen to be, you don't like the sight of blood. Okay. Put that aside. Okay, so the next sample is a saliva sample, okay? So, I just need you to say, open your mouth, and I'm gonna just run this over your tongue and obtain some saliva sample, okay? So, here we go. There we go. Okay, excellent. If you put that aside as well. Okay. from you is a hair sample. A hair sample. Just from your head, okay? Very painless. A little, quick little pull and a... tiny little amount of pain, but very brief. Just right about there. Yeah, looks good. There we go. Perfect. All right. Okay, I just need to make a few notes that I obtained your DNA samples in just a minute. Blood. Obtained hair sample. And a saliva sample. Forgot. I like to perform a little sketch of you. I could easily take a picture of you, but I'm just kind of old-fashioned, so I'm going to draw a little sketch to have your image in our records, okay? So just say, you have the most remarkable features of all the abductees that I've obtained samples from. I think your DNA is going to be the one. I really do. Right now, at this very moment, there are thousands of other humans who have been abducted. I know that's a strong word, but you know, straight to the point. But there's about a little over a dozen of us obtaining DNA samples aside from the captain of the ship and the maintenance staff, the doctor, etc. So they have their normal ship duties, but then there are those of us who are responsible for obtaining, extracting the DNA. I prefer to extract DNA through blood, saliva, and hair. But some of my co-workers extract the DNA in other manners, other ways that I don't really like. But to each their own. Okay. But anyway... so, yeah, we are trying to find that very special, perfect DNA. And I think your DNA is going to be the one. I really do. And if it is, I get an extra bonus commission for finding the perfect DNA to splice with our DNA to create the perfect alien race. So, the reason we need to splice your DNA with ours is because our DNA has been corrupted. We can no longer reproduce. So, we're gonna, from the DNA samples that I obtained from you, take the DNA from that, splice it with my DNA, or someone else's. We're all the same. Okay, anyway, let me finish the sketch. Okay. Nose, mouth. Okay, I think that's, yeah, it's a spitting image. All right. Oh, hey, do you like magic tricks? I'm a part-time magician, too. All my alien co-workers, they love my magic tricks. So, here's a magic trick. I have this empty hat. Okay, you can see. There's nothing inside. Say a few magic words, and pull something out of this hat, okay? Are you ready for the greatest magic trick you've ever seen? Okay. Ma casa la bonta senti la tua. Abracadabra. Just reach into the hat, see? And lo and behold, presto magico. Like that. So what do you think? Was that a great magic trick? Thank you very much. Okay. 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 Now, I'm sure you were wondering this session, I guess we could say, involves you being probed, and it does. I'm going to probe you, okay? And so what this does, this little device, this invention of alien science, it will read your temperature, your body temperature. and various other vital systems, such as your heartbeat, your pulse, your breathing, the amount of oxygen you're taking in, the activity in your brain. So it's a multifunction probe, okay? And I'm just going to gently just rest it, different parts, over your heart, your lungs, your head, etc. Don't worry, I'm not going to stick this probe anywhere you would like it to be stuck, okay? I know there's a... I've heard about you humans and your generalization. Some of the previous abductees that we extracted DNA from that were, you know, not the greatest DNA. They shared their experiences and said that we stick our probes in places that you really shouldn't stick a probe. So, no. We're not like that, okay? So, all right. I'm just gonna stick the probe right there. Get a good reading. Okay. Very excellent brain activity. I just want to place this over your heart. Very good. Your heart is very strong. Okay, now I'm going to probe your lungs. Okay, so. Wonderful. Wow, amazing readings. I think you are the perfect specimen. I think that your DNA, you're going to be the one to help propagate our species, to create the perfect alien race. Yes, I really do. I mean, these readings are off the charts. I've never seen. Just amazing. Okay. Well, that's going to do it for the probing. Would you mind? I hope you don't mind if I remove your brain, take a look at it, just to ensure you really are going to be the one. You don't mind? Okay, excellent. I'm just going to reach out here and while you were sleeping, because in order to abduct you, bring you on board our vessel, I gave you a little bit of a sleeping gas, knocked you out for a few hours, and I already did some preliminary incisions into your skull, your scalp, so that I can easily remove your brain. Okay, so I'm going to do that right now. It should be relatively painless. Okay, all right. Let's just get your brain. Well, just look at your brain. Such a beautiful specimen. Perfect in every way. Just look at that cerebral cortex and all those wrinkles. And that brainstem. I mean, frontal lobe, parietal lobe. I must say, you, my friend, you have the perfect brain. I just knew you were going to be the one when I showed up while you were sleeping. Put the gas in your room, knocked you out, beamed you up here onto our spaceship. I just knew, in the third heart of my seven hearts, that you were going to be the one to help propagate our species. And just look at this brain. I mean, that says it all. One look. Okay, you can have your brain back. Examine some of your features up close. So just a moment. Okay, my friend, I have this thin light, another invention of alien science. And I'm just going to take a look at your pupils, some of the other features of your eyes, okay? Just to ensure. Just to make sure that you are, in fact, the perfect specimen. I'm really sure of that, confident, 1,000%. In alien civilization, our percentages go up to 1,000. That's how advanced we are. Not to mention, I mean, a pen light. A pen that produces light. It's not really a pen. It looks like one. But I'm sure your species is not quite as advanced like us to create something like this. Anyway, maybe one day you'll get there. So, I'm going to shine this in your eyes. Okay, so, just look straight ahead. Okay, so, just look straight ahead. Right here at my head. Just look at my beautiful cranium. Is that not the most beautiful thing you've ever seen? While your human brain is very advanced, just look at the size of my skull. Our brains are about five times as big as your brains. Just massive, massive intellect. I don't mean to make you feel bad. I mean, your species is pretty good. You evolved from apes. That's pretty good. You should be proud. But just look at this massive skull. Don't you wish you had this kind of intellect, brain power? Look at that, man. Look at that. Isn't that awesome? How about I tap on my... Just relax to the sounds of the pads of my fingers tapping away at my eyes, my massive skull and intellect. Just go ahead and look. Go ahead and look straight at me. Okay? And I'm gonna look straight at you. Wow. Look at those pupils. Just amazing. I knew you were the one. I knew it. And look at those crunkles. Amazing. The little fleshy little parts in the corner of your eyes. And those are crunkles. Wow. You just have amazing features. Okay, can you open up and say, oh, I just want to take a look inside your mouth there. Look at those teeth. Excellent. I knew you were going to be the one. I just knew it. My intuition was right. My coworkers laughed at me. They say, no way. Because we have friendly competition here. Who's going to be the one to find the perfect human specimen to propagate our species, to splice with our DNA? And they're always laughing at me because I haven't had any success. Some of my, most of my other coworkers have. But you are going to help me. But you are going to help me to be the one that found a perfect DNA, perfect human specimen. Okay, so this is another invention of advanced alien civilization. This is called a stethoscope, okay? Again, something we invented. And this allows us to listen to your internal organs. So I'm gonna... I should have done this earlier. But I'm gonna listen. I'm gonna listen to your heart. I'm gonna listen to your lungs. Okay? So just remain where you are. Take a listen. Yep. Just like the probe. The readings on the probe indicated you have a very strong heart. Now, I want to listen to your lungs. Just breathe. You can inhale and exhale. Okay, again, inhale. And exhale. Excellent. All right. You see, stethoscope, alien invention. Okay, so I am so impressed by your crunkles that I want to measure your crunkles, if that's okay with you. I'm not sure if anyone has ever measured your crunkles before. Remember, fleshy parts in the corners of your eye. Crunkles, okay. Crunkle. That's a nice ring to it. Crunkle. just measure your left coracle. Okay. All right. And now I'm going to measure your right coracle. Okay. All right. Okay. Well, just amazing. Even your coracles are out of this world. And I thought I would take this time to share with you some of the DNA of the other humans that we've obtained. Read off some of the names. These are the ones I have personally obtained. Tupac Shakur. Abraham Lincoln. Jimi Hendrix. Bruce Lee. Sidney Poitier, Kurt Cobain, Michael Jackson, Elvis Presley. Let's see. Douglas Adams. H.P. Lovecraft. Carl Sagan. And while all of those are good, a lot of those samples just not up to par. But then there's you. Just know you're the one. I can't wait to analyze your DNA. Actually, let me do that real quick right now with my DNA analyzing machine. Just a moment. Okay. I've put your DNA into this container. This is a container. It has a lid. Another advanced invention of big brain alien civilization. I'm just gonna mix your DNA around. Just like that. Just mix it around. Get all the DNA particles. Okay. I know you didn't see it earlier, but when I took your DNA samples out, I put them in here. So I'm going to pop the lid and we're going to see if your DNA is the DNA that I'm hoping it to be. see that your DNA has the exact type of DNA stuff. I don't want to bore you with all science-y nomenclature and what the DNA stuff is really, what it really is, okay? Stuff is good enough for now. Yeah, I can tell your DNA is the one. Just by looking at your DNA in that container and analyzing it with my massive alien intellect. Very massive. You know what they say about massive alien intellect and skulls and brains? Hey, just look at these fingers. Have you ever seen fingers like that? Okay, my friend, well, I think that's gonna do it at this time. It looks to me, in this light, you look a little sleepy and drowsy. It's probably the effects of the sleeping gas I administered to abduct you. So let me help you get back to sleep, okay? And then I'm going to return you to your home, unless you would like to stay here and be my guest and go on grand adventures all throughout the universe and watch as we splice your DNA with ours. And you can watch your children grow up, half human, half alien. Children grow up. So you can do that, but if you like, you can stay with us. But for now, it's time to sleep. Thank you very much for your cooperation. I appreciate it. And hopefully we can remain lifelong friends. But now, just sleep. Sleep, my friend. Sleep knowing that you have helped our species.